scheduled for one fall.
One fall!
Introducing first, he's weighing in at 220 pounds from the wrong side of the tracks, the runaway Skyler.
Well, here we go. Action here on AFCW Overdrive. We have Luca Mancini taking on Skyler Kincaid. I'm Fast Freddy here with CJD and CJT. What about your opinion on these two bouts here?
Well, this is Luca Mancini's first time in AFCW. And although he's in his 30s, he's relatively new to the professional wrestling scene, as he only started in December of 2019.
30 just about as old as I am.
32 years old.
I'm 31.
But, and also, we all know Skyler Kincaid and what he can do in the ring. He's got a long standing run here in AFCW, and definitely not somebody to trifle with.
Skyler Kincaid, well known. He did a lot of dangerous bouts. The last man standing match, you have AJ Chance, and I ended up having to referee that.
Finish the match as a referee. And, As you can see, Skyler's got the size advantage here over Luca, but Luca doesn't take size into consideration when he's in the ring. He fights with all of his heart, and he just keeps going until he can't go anymore. And it was a nice arm drag and now an armbar by Luca Mancini onto Skyler Kincaid.
Now, Luca Mancini, he trained out in East Stroudsburg, is that correct?
That's true, yeah. Under the tutelage of Junior Soba.
And you have Skyler Kincaid, who trained at Backbreakers?
Backbreakers under Justin Glory, that's correct.
Oh, you're good friends with Justin Glory.
Yes, I am. Oh, big punch right in the face. And as much as that's illegal, of course, referee David Stone isn't going to...
I think sometimes he's incompetent. Yeah, I've seen other refs, and he's not as bad as the other refs.
Oh, hard whip into the buckle and an explosive clothesline.
I don't know if that's giving him credit. Maybe a little bit.
Explosive clothesline from Skyler Kincaid, and one thing I gotta point out with Skyler Kincaid's clotheslines, if you notice, he doesn't wind back.
Oh,
that's a hard body slam right there, shouting at our production crew.
Which they are the fans, because we're not allowed to have fans, so we just decided to improvise and use our production crew. It's like, well, you're coming to fans today.
But to get back to what I was saying, Skyler Kincaid's clotheslines, and I didn't think that was going to keep Luka down. Skyler Kincaid's clothesline. A clothesline is meant to drop your opponent, knock the wind out of him. With Skyler's, he does a short burst, so he doesn't use a lot of momentum, but he also doesn't use a lot of energy throwing that arm. He keeps it short, and when he hits, he doesn't hit just to knock you down. He hits you to stay down. That's why those clotheslines of his are so dangerous. Some shots right to the ribs.
And boy, the Mancini is feeling it right now.
Absolutely is. Mancini's up in the air and a down. What a suplex.
I think they felt that in the first row.
We're the first row.
Oh, I forgot we are the first row. Yeah, my bad. Again, we can't have fans here. We're in an undisclosed location. Jersey. Sorry about that.
No, that's okay.
Yeah,
allergies.
Something in my throat with allergy season, not COVID season.
And Skyler's back in Mancini up, whips him off, ducks the line, ducks another line.
There we go.
Head scissor takeover, drops him on his face.
Nicely done by Mancini.
Yeah, it looks like Skyler's reeling from that one. Oh, and a boot to the face.
Oh, wow. I think he's seeing stars now, Mancini. Well, Menzies is showing him some stars of his own here.
Yeah, Showtime's got some stars on his gear, but what's up? Oh!
An inverted stunner!
It looked like he was going for a reverse twist of fate, turned into a stunner. One, two, and no.
Oh, I thought he had that one.
I thought that was it, but as we know, Skyler Kincaid is very, very resistant.
I haven't seen that move done with an inverted stunner. Whew. That looks nice.
Very nice. I liked it. And Luka now, spinning back kick. He's going for his famouser. No, just not getting it. And an atomic drop.
Oh, the south of the border is going to feel that one.
The bad thing about there's one of those explosive closings. Like I said, he doesn't spend much energy going back with the arm. He just keeps it there and throws it as hard as he can in a backbreaker.
And there he goes, wrenching the back on Mancini. That's an awkward position. Oh!
That short little space between his from the knee to the mat doesn't look like a lot of space, but he threw him down, not just dropping him.
Skyler thought he had it there. Referee Stone said two.
Well, it looks like Skyler's calling for the finish. Well, he sets him up. Ripcord grabs him. Oh, this is it. And that's it. That's Skyler Kincaid's finish. We can count that all day. Three.
Good night, Mancini. Skyler Kincaid picks up the win here on Overdrive. Here we go, tag team action on Overdrive. I'm Fat Freddy here with CJG, and we have the Cowboy Kings taking on the throne.
Yep, the throne here, not new to AFCW, where the Cowboy Kings are, although they both look very, very familiar.
I can't chemically put this together, but I don't know.
It seems like they got a very close relationship. You saw them getting, you know, close to each other, you know, butting heads together, and then... So it looks like they've been to warfare together, you know?
Right, exactly.
But in the ring now we have
Devin Thrasher with Batsu Kusanagi.
Batsu Kusanagi.
Yeah, I wonder if I said that right. No, I didn't when I did comment when I did ring announcement.
You did say it right this time, and there's some elbows to the wrist to weaken the waist lock. And there you got a top wrist lock. So with the throne you have in the ring Batsu Kusanagi with Daniel Riley on the outside.
Daniel Riley, Keith Riley, are they even brothers? One coming north, one coming south. Am I wrong with this?
No, not at all.
One went to royalty, one went to the farm.
Looks like a shoulder tackle. He goes to run off, but stops when he sees that Batsu's down.
One went to the royal family, and the other one went to work for their farm.
Yeah, he tries to help Batsu up. Batsu don't want any part of it.
Hey man, well Batsu is a little arrogant as I've seen him patrolling around, but you can't blame him. He wants to be all, you know, pinkies up, martinis in my glass, where is my butler type of motif.
Oh, well, that's the lifestyle of the throne. It's they're the royals, and on the outside for the Cowboy Kings is Keith Riley. And then there's a lockup between Thrasher and And Devin, Devin Thrasher and Batsu again. He whips Devin off. Another shoulder tackle.
Taken down, Kusanagi.
Whips him off, drop down. Leapfrog, catches him into a side belly-to-belly suplex.
Nicely done.
That was very nicely and innovatively done by Devin Thrasher.
Cowboy King, I think they can get along down in this area of the United States.
There's a lot of farmland in New Jersey they can work on.
True, and mushroom farms are nearby. I just thought it was Stone's refereeing that stunk, but I guess it was the mushroom farm next door.
Probably. And Keith Riley tug in, jumps off the back of Devin Thrasher to deliver a clothesline to Batsu in the corner. There's a little bit of fired up there. That's a good sign for early on from the Cowboy Kings. And a neck breaker.
I guess he has faith in himself.
He must. He must have faith in himself. Speaking of faith, remember the Faith Network here on Overdrive?
Yeah, it lasted like 2 episodes, and I'm pretty sure it was canceled due to Dominic Truex.
Yeah, it probably was. But another tag in to
I think we should bring that back, but you know, time will tell. I have to meet with production anyway, and we'll go over it, but...
And a double suplex!
As of right now, I think it's been canceled.
Devin Thrasher with the cover. 1, 2... this ref seems to be going a little slow, in my opinion, here.
I've seen it a couple of times in his matches. You go slow, and then you're wondering to yourself, why is he doing that? You have to be consistent pace throughout the match.
Correct.
Could be slow in the beginning, but you got to have a consistent rhythm. Because I used to referee.
Yep.
Consistent rhythm. Because you just never know. You never know what's going
to
be
the finish. Short to the ropes. Duck the line. There's a blind tag. Oh! Daniel Riley with a stiff kick right to the stomach.
Kusanagi taken down.
Taking Devin Thrasher down with the knees. And then a kick to the face. And Devin Thrasher's literally thrashing on the ground.
That doesn't sound good.
Nope. Devin Thrasher's still in it. 1, 2 again.
He's not going to get a pin in that way.
No, you're not.
He didn't have the shoulders down all the way. Easy for a kick out. Here we go, whipping them against the ropes here. Chop, you can hear that all the way in the back.
And a big slap from Devin Thrasher.
Just whips him into the corner tag. Here comes Kusanagi in.
Does a leg slip. Riley drops.
Didn't even faze him.
Oh, and a big slap to Keith Riley. Well, I think all that did was tick him off a little bit. We're not PG. We can say it. He got pissed off with that slap. And a cover. 1, 2, kick out.
But that was really slow on that cover.
That was a lot slower. Maybe they...
We never said we were PG.
We are not PG. I will say that. We are not PG here at AMCW. Definitely not on Overdrive. And a suplex. Into a Falcon Arrow.
Nicely done by Kusanagi.
2. And that looked like it was almost a 3. But
saved by Keith Riley.
I think it was a mutual save and kick out from the Cowboy Kings entirely. Kusanagi now smacking Thrasher's head off the top turnbuckle, keeping him there for his tag team partner to get in. Riley with a shot that had got Daniel Riley, I should say.
And then the referee is just allowing this to happen, having both guys in the ring at the same time.
Drop kick to the feet, and then a knee drop to the back of the head.
I could just about
cover. 1, 2, and a kick out. It seems like the ref might be pissed off here at the throne.
That could be the reason why he's coming from.
That could be.
That could be a very good reason.
Although we don't disagree with it, this is why you don't mess with the referees of your match.
That is very true.
Now he's got him on the rope and he's choking him. He's got his leg draped over and sitting on the throat of Devin Thrasher. Anytime you can take air out of your opponent's lungs, it gives you an advantage.
Second here, what's he planning to do now? Looks like Thrasher wants
collision right into each other.
And here comes a tag, in comes Keith Riley.
Clothesline. And another clothesline. Keith Riley's on fire. Looking at the clothesline. That wasn't a drop kick, that was like a jumping sidekick. And a big body slam from Keith Riley fired up right here. Cover 1, 2. And that was not going to keep Daniel Riley down. the battle of the Rileys in the ring right now, Keith and Daniel.
Riley on Riley? Who can eventually say that?
If we get Tucker Riley in this match.
Oh, and then Riley Crowe.
And then Riley Crowe can perfect.
So many Rileys in just one ring.
A push off. Daniel Riley gets picked up and dropped onto the stomach. He looks like he's in a lot of pain right there, Daniel Riley. Now, Keith. He's picking up Daniel. Here comes Devin Thrasher off the ropes, it looks. And a big kick drops him. That could be it. That's one, two, and three.
That's it. The Cowboy Kings take this victory here on Overdrive. The Cowboy
Was Rude Wayne from the start, doesn't even let him get checked out all the way from the ref, and he comes in barreling with a European uppercut into the corner, and now some chops from the Lucha King onto Jeff Hawk.
Let's see, Felipe, he wanted to strike early, and
oh!
He's going to point across, but Jeff, no stranger to that action.
Nope, clothesline to Jeff Hawk, a big fan favorite here in AFCW, High Flyer Supreme, Skate and Bake.
That's a good motto.
It is.
Except I can't skate. Maybe bake. I don't know.
I mean, the only baking I think I'm allowed to do is in the kitchen, but we all know that the baking that's going on right now is the ass-whipping that Felipe was just getting. But very quickly, tables turn.
Can't say ass-whipping, maybe.
Oh, I can say whatever we want to say. This is not PG. This is AFCW.
That's true.
Now, Felipe just yelling him in the face and choking the life out of Jeff Hawk.
And yelling at the referee. I don't think he's yelling in Spanish. I'm teaching him how to say 1, 2, 3 in Spanish, which I can do. Almost all stress. I know some Spanish words. And some curse words, too, but I'm not going to say it right now.
And Jeff Hawk getting up. Bring him back down. Looks like he's going to hit him with a suplex. And he does. Nice suplex with a bridge.
Into a bridge, but the referee was out of position.
That could have easily been maybe a two count. I mean, even if it was just a one count, just to make your opponent use the energy to kick out.
Referee was definitely
out of position. Two suplexes on the Jeff Hawk. There's a cover one. He wasn't even covering him for that two. He literally just let him go.
The referee still counted two.
And again, so that was a one count. Now he's got him, it looks like, by the dreads or by the ears. Picking Jeff Hawk up from the ground. He breaks it, pops him right in the face, and Jeff Hawk is now trying to reel and get ready. A big back elbow from Jeff Hawk. Calculate another one.
The fiery offense of Jeff Hawk.
Nice and quick, beautiful drop kick by Jeff Hawk. There's a cover one, and only a one count. But hey, that's just get your opponent to kick out and make some use their energy, and that's less energy they can use on you later.
And then Felipe taking the time to ring awareness, getting out of the ring to catch a breath.
That also gives a breath to Jeff Hawk as well. Let's him try to rewire from that the beating he was getting from Felipe earlier on.
Jeff taunting him to come in the ring.
And Jeff doesn't want a breath. He wants to keep going. And with the way he seems like he has endless cardio, this guy. Felipe, not saying that he doesn't have the cardio, he just likes to take his time and get ahead of his opponents, and it looks like that's what he's trying to do.
Nothing wrong with that. Play a mind game, we'll work for his advantage.
Lock up, it looks like equal strength there. Jeff Hawk with a knee to try to get the advantage. Gets him into the ropes in the corner, and there's a big shot. He keeps Felipe in the corner. Oh, and a big crossbody into the corner. That was beautiful. He's calling for another one. And there's another one.
Nicely done.
They were beautifully done by Jeff Hawk. Throws Felipe over the top. Gives him a knee shot. Another knee. He's calling for something here. And he moves. Oh! Like he was going to do a suicide, a spear onto Felipe. But he brings up that foot and kicks him in the face instead.
Felipe
now with a jumping neck breaker, like a front neck breaker, clothesline type maneuver. And Jeff Hawk is just moving around, just dead off the ground. And a crossbody. One, two, kick out by Jeff Hawk.
That wasn't going to do it. He thought he had it there, but nope.
And Jeff Hawk is on autopilot, just trying to keep himself going. Oh, Felipe really, really irritated that that was only a two count.
And he was yelling at the referee. Well, where did we get the referee? I'm not sure.
I have no clue.
I don't think it came from Randy.
Stepping on the face. One. Not just a one. And Felipe is just insulting Jeff Hawk here. Don't do that. Don't take him too lightly. Jeff Hawk don't take that crap. Yeah, Jeff Hawk is, like I said, he's getting him in the corner, just firing some shots off. And a big right hand. And he whips Felipe. Felipe got stuck between the top and the middle ropes.
And you have to watch for that. Any like arms or limbs can get stuck between the two ropes. I know that happened to me.
Yes, they can. Jeff Hawk on the top rope. Diving to the outside. Oh my God. No referee
and
checking.
There's not much padding on the floor, let me tell you.
There isn't at all. And Jeff Hawk, the suicidal high flyer himself. He reminds me sort of like an ECW guy. He reminds me of like a Sabu.
That's what I was thinking too with the hair.
I was thinking just more of the style. He loves the high flying, and he'll put himself on line before he gives up. And he crotched him up there. And there's the Lucha Driver. That could be it. One, two, and three.
That's it. The Lucha King gets his victory here on Overdrive.
Mr. Motivation,
Overdrive. We have Tucker Riley, Eddie Velasquez in the ring. We have Corporal Soft.
Sap.
My bad. I knew I was going to get that wrong on the notes here. We have Tyler Ash, AJ Tense, and Casey Lycan.
Yes, sir. We have a bunch of newcomers to AEW in this match. Three newcomers and three, I don't want to say vets of AEW, but three men who've been around AEW for a bit. Casey Lycan, John Saft, and Tyler Ash making their debuts here for AFCW, especially on Overdrive. And then you have AJ Chance, who we all know had wars with Skyler Kincaid, Eddie Velasquez, Mr. Motivation, and the man screaming from Mr. Motivation, Tucker Riley.
Well, he's doing sit-ups and using Tucker's leg as leverage.
Yes, he is. And there's some leverage right there just tossing Eddie like he's nothing.
Eddie has that effect on
Tucker Riley, big man, big heart. Seems like he's always on a roll but gets stopped short at times. Ooh! Short kick right to the knees. Casey Lycan. Impressive showing right off the bat.
See, Casey saw a weakness body part and decided to exploit it. Or now he's trying to choke him out. Either way.
Yeah, he's trying to. He gets that arm underneath the armpit to try to choke him out even more by suffocating the arm as well. And Casey, being probably the smallest guy in the ring, is now on top of and keeping the biggest man down.
Oh,
probably not for long.
Whoa. Oh, he's gonna find his way out of it!
Yeah, he's very squirmy and he bounces out of the ring. And the fascinating thing about this match is the amp qualifier match is a 6-man lucha rules, every man for himself, with a 1-fall finish. So you don't have to be tug in. You can come in, throw one of your opponents out, or if there's an opening to come in, just run on in. And that's what makes this match different than other matches.
See, that's what makes us different than the other promotions. You don't see this at all.
You do not. This was a match that was first originated in Florida from the promotion Amp Wrestling, hence the Amp title, the aptly named and respected by AFCW for the originality of this type of match.
Well, Tyler for the cover, but Soft was able to...
Saft.
I'm never going to get that right.
Saft. It's an A, not an O. And Tyler Ash stomping on the hands.
I'm sorry, it was hot in this game.
Tyler Ash is smacking Corporal Saft around. Goes for a suplex. That was a no. Goes for another. That's a no. Saft gets Tyler Ash up and over. I gotta say, Tyler Ash has a striking resemblance to our one and only Draven Blaze, doesn't he?
Yeah.
That could be his long lost son.
And now we're going possibly.
And now AJ Chance in the ring. Now AJ's another big guy, a big softy as well when it comes to liking people. Very easy to get along with. But don't take them lightly. And here we are, the two biggest men now in the ring.
Here we go, tail of the giants here. Well, that'd be at least, like, what, 6 feet, you think?
What's that?
Both at least about 6 feet.
Well, they're over 6 feet. AJ Chance is about 6'3", 6'4", and Tucker Riley about the same, 6'4", maybe 6'5".
And Stone referee's like a whopping 5'6", probably. I mean, who booked him as the referee in this matchup? He's not all Lucha.
No, the referee doesn't have to be Lucha. And a whip into the ropes. And a big boot from Tucker Riley.
Here comes the cover.
Two. As you see, like, they're trying to break up the cover because this is a one-fall finish. It's not elimination style. This is a one-fall finish match. It makes it extremely dangerous for all involved.
I'm just saying, what happens if the referee decides to hit the final opponent and count himself to three? Does that count?
No, it does not.
Okay. I'm just clarifying the rules.
Tucker Riley takes big AJ Chance in the corner, shoving some shoulders into him. It looks like a little chop to AJ Chance. I got to Tyler Asher tagging there. Instead of just giving him a polite tag, he's like, here, one for the road. Oh, big drop kick right to the face of AJ Chance. Drops him. Ash is struggling to pull him to the middle, and then a one, two.
Oh, but Tucker with the save. Looks like he tagged himself in.
Well,
you did?
In a match like this, there's not really being tugged in. You can tag in, but unless you're in the ring.
Tucker on the side here. Tucker is going to war with AJ.
Well, in the ring, we have Eddie Velasquez trying to shoot wrestle with AJ Chance here. Get a low base on the big man, but AJ Chance is a big guy. Look at that spread there. One, two, and a kick out. Oh,
look at that reversal.
That reversal right into what looks to be an ankle lock.
Can he connect with it? He does.
He's got it, but he doesn't have it all the way because Eddie Velasquez is trying to get out of the way. Rolls. AJ still has it.
Oh, got to the rope. Got to the rope in time.
But AJ Chance stomps on the foot.
One for good measure.
Absolutely. And it looks like everybody's waiting on somebody. Nobody wants to take the move. Casey Lycan jumps down. He don't want any part of AJ.
So AJ Saft is just sitting there. Did you get that right?
Yep, Saft. Okay.
I got it. I know I was going to mess up since I read the lines here.
That's okay. Well, AJ Chance was respectful and let Eddie get out of the corner of his own fruition there. Oh, quick kick right to the stomach. That'll drop most men anyway. Knock the wind out of him. It looks like he's trying to roll him over with an... Oh, he's going for the Fujiwara armbar.
I think he got it in.
It does. It looks like he's got it. And that's a move that can separate the elbow and the shoulder. If he locks it in a certain way, he can get the wrist, elbow, and shoulder at the same time.
Will he tap? Will he submit?
Now with AJ chin up, he's got the ropes. Use those long limbs. Oh! Hey, kicks that arm right off the ropes.
Oh, wait, but here comes Saft in the ring now. And he's going for the cover. Eddie does not see that.
Eddie just sitting in a corner.
If Eddie would have just let him get the pinfall, that'd be interesting.
Yeah,
he did all the work, but here, you can get the pin. Where have I seen that before?
And AJ just pushes Saft out of the ring.
Uh-oh. Now here comes Tucker Riley.
The two big men again.
I think maybe
they're running up, and Tucker Riley pulls low bridges for AJ Chance. AJ gets dumped out of the ring.
Here comes KC.
KC with a huge up and over sliced bread.
Nicely done.
What's going on? That's Skyler Kincaid. What's he doing with AJ Chance?
Hey! What's he doing with? Does that get a camera on him?
And there might have been camera footage, but. Action in the ring is still going on. AJ Chance, I guess, is no longer part of the match. And Seth, with a huge standing spine buster, points and does his trigger fingers at Casey Lycan, indicating that he just took him out. And here comes Eddie Velasquez with the moto train on Saft.
Could that just about do it?
That could do it. That's one, two, and Tucker Riley saves his shot at getting the AMP or the AMP title match against Justin Henry later. He's setting up. That, uh-oh. He grabs him. Big hands on the side.
And he's trying to fight it.
He's trying to fight it. He slips out, but he's got his tights still. Tucker's still got his tights. He's got them. Oh, man.
One for the money, two for that show.
And I would say one, two, three. Tyler. Tucker Riley goes on against Justin Henry later for the AM title.
Here on our